Is this thing on? Are we on? Hey, it's I guess this could maybe be the first installment, depending if they put it on the website or not, or the second installment of something that we call the D list. We're Dominski and Doyle. The D list is sort of like, wasn't even good enough to be a B list, never made it onto the air, but hey, we have the story, so we're gonna share them.
What do you want first? You want powdered alcohol or surgery to correct penises?
Let's go with surgery.
Well, there's
because this one I haven't heard.
There's a Canadian study that says surgery to change penis appearance may not do much to stop locker room teasing in high school. Apparently, this was such a problem that they needed to have a study done on it. 47% had seen others being teased about their penises, and out of those, 83% were oversized, and only a third of them were about it looking funny. What they're basically saying is, if you get your child circumcised later, he's still going to get made fun of for something.
Okay. Well, this sort of goes hand in hand. Now, depending on when you see this, this may have already happened, but Saturday the 14th, Morristown, huge 80,000-person crowd expected for the St. Patrick's Day Parade. And certain body parts may be exposed because they have been having a huge problem in the past with public urination. And back in 2012, they had to hike the fines for this. This was this bad of a problem. In fact, one judge about 2 years ago, a local judge there, said, "We encourage people to come to Morristown and enjoy all it has to offer, but some streets, when it rains, smell like urine." So that's what he said. That's a quote. They hiked the fine 3 years ago from $250 to $500 for a first-time offender who urinates on a public street. And, Bill, it also includes the other.
No kidding, they do that too?
They're apparently, yeah.
Enough to make it smell? Because it says smells like urine.
If you apparently they've had some poopers.
Wow.
And,
that's a party.
Now, repeat offenders can face a $1,000 fine. And if you're repeating that offense,
That meant you went number two.
Yeah. Now, are you number two on number one or number two on number two? I need a sidebar, Your Honor.
All right, the alcohol, powdered alcohol, that was approved, then they withdrew the approval. Well, it's been approved again. So look for it sometime this summer where you just, it's like Kool-Aid. You take powder, you pour it in water, you stir it for 60 seconds, instant booze.
Isn't that a little dangerous?
Well, you know, people are saying, well, what if people snort it and the inventor, whatever, the provider is saying, it takes 60 minutes to snort a whole packet of powdered alcohol where you could just make a shot and drink it in 2 seconds. So nobody's going to be snorting it.
I'm not even sure why he knows that stat.
Apparently, that was going to be a concern. Also, they say, well, couldn't you spike a drink with it? And they point out it's a lot easier to spike a drink with liquid alcohol because the powdered stuff has to be stirred for 60 seconds.
Okay, so Bill Cosby was interested and then passed it by.
That's right.
Gotcha. All right. This is another edition of the D-List. We're Dominski and Doyle, Mondays through Fridays, 2 to 7 on New Jersey, 101.5.